Dear students, welcome to Study and Learn Academy. Today we will continue the lecture Environmental History. So in 1929, a group of French historians founded the journal Annales, in many ways a forerunner of modern environmental history, since it took as its subject matter the reciprocal global influence of the environment and human society. The idea of the impact of the physical environment on civilization was espoused by these Annales schools to describe the long-term developments that shape human history by focusing away from political and intellectual history. Towards agriculture, demography, and geography. Ray Landurel, a pupil of the Annales School, was the first to really, in the 1950s, environmental history in a more contemporary form. One of the most influential members of the Annales School was Lucien Febvre, 1878 to 1956. Whose 1922 book, A Geographical Introduction to History, is now a classical in the field. The most influential empirical and theoretical work in the subject has been done in the United States, where teaching programs first emerged and a generation of trained environmental historians is now active. In the United States, environmental history as an independent field of study emerged in the general cultural reassessment and reform of the 1960s and 1970s, along with environmentalism, conservation history, and a gathering awareness of the global scale of some environmental issues. This was in large part of a reaction to the way nature was represented in history at the time, which portrayed the advance of culture and technology as releasing humans from dependence on the natural world and providing them with the means to manage it. Celebrated humans' mastery forms of life and the natural environment, and experimental technological improvement and economic growth to accelerate. Environmental historians intended to develop a post-colonial historiography that was more inclusive in its narratives. Morals and political inspiration. Moral and political inspiration to environmental historians has come from American writers and activists such as Henry Thoreau, John Muller, Aldo Leopold, and Rachel Carson. Environmental history frequently promoted a moral and political agenda, although it steadily became a more scholarly enterprise. Early attempts to define the field were made in the United States by Roderick Nash in The State of Environmental History, and in other works by frontier historians Frederick Laxon Turner, James Mullin, and Waller Prescott Webb, who analyzed the process of settlement. Their work was expanded by a second generation, or especially environmental historians such as Crosby, Hayes, Donald Wester, William Cronin, Richard White, Carolyn Merchem, J.R. McNeil, Donald Hughes, and Chad Monterey in the United States, and Paul Wade, Walker Solin, Robert A. Lambert, T.C. Smout, and Peter Coates in Europe. British Empire. Although environmental history was growing rapidly as a field after 1970 in the United States, it only reached historians of the British Empire in the 1990s. Gregory Bouton argues that the concept of environmentalism emerged from forestry studies and emphasizes the British imperial role in that research. He argues that empirical forestry movement in India around 1900 included government variations, new methods of fire protection, and attention to revenue producing forest management. The result is the fight between romantic preservationists and laissez faire businessmen, thus giving the compromise from which modern environmentalism emerged. In recent years, numerous scholars cited by James Batty have examined the environmental impact of the empire. Bernard and Hughes argue that the discovery and commercial or scientific use of new plants was an important concern in the 18th and 19th centuries. The efficient use of rivers through dams and irrigation projects was an expensive but important method of raising agricultural productivity. Searching for more efficient ways of using natural resources, the British moved flora, fauna, and commodities around the world, sometimes resulting in ecological disruptions and radical environmental change. Also stimulated more modern attitudes toward nature and subsidized botany and agriculture research. Scholars have used the British Empire to examine the utility of the new concept of eco-cultural networks as a lens for examining interconnected, wide-ranging social and environmental processes. Current practice. In the United States, the American Society for Environmental History was founded in 1975. While the first institute devoted specifically to environmental history in Europe was established in 1991, based at the University of St. Andrews in Scotland. In 1986, the Dutch Foundation for the History of Environment and Hygiene Works was founded and publishes 4 newsletters per year. In the UK, the Whitehorn Press in Cambridge has since 1995 published the journal Environment and History, which aims to bring scholars in the humanities and biological sciences closer together in constructing long and well-founded perspectives on present-day environmental problems and similar publications. Journal for Environment History is a combined Flemish-Dutch initiative mainly dealing with the topics in the Netherlands and Belgium, although it is also has an interest in European environmental history. Europe Mountains Abstract in English, French and German in 1999 was converted into a yearbook for environmental history. In Canada, the Canadian History and Human and Environment facilitates the growth of environmental history through numerous workshops and a significant digital infrastructure, including their website and podcast. Communication between European nations is restricted by language difficulties. In April 1999, a meeting was held in Germany to overcome these problems and to coordinate environmental history in Europe. This meeting resulted in the creation of the European in 1999. Only 2 years after its establishment, ESEH held its first international conference in St. Andrews, Scotland. Around 120 scholars attended the meeting and 105 papers were presented in topics covering the whole spectrum of environmental history. The conference showed that environmental history is a viable and lively field in Europe, and since then ESEH has expanded to over 400 members and continues to grow and attracted international conference in 2003 and 2005. In 1999, the Center for Environmental History was established at the University of Stirling. Some history departments at European universities are now offering introductory courses in environmental history, and postgraduate courses in environmental histories have been established at the universities of Nottingham, Stirling and Dundee, and more recently a graduate college was created at the University of Konkens in Germany. So So this is all about the today's lecture. Thank you very much. Goodbye.